is another golden opportunity that you have met to hear the word of God. So set yourself and then we hear the word of God this afternoon. I want to speak God of covenant. Mungu wa ahadi. God of covenant. A covenant is an agreement between two people. The Bible has so many examples of covenant. Even in marriage, it's a covenant. Two people agree that they shall walk together in good times, in bad times. Amen. It's a covenant. Even in God, when I gave myself to Christ, I made a covenant that I will make Christ Jesus as my Lord and my Lordship and my Savior. Hallelujah. This afternoon, as we learn about God of covenant, our first reading, it's a promise from God. Isaiah 45 from verse 2. I'll go before you. I'll make crooked places straight. I'll break in pieces gates of bronze and cut asada of bronze of iron. I'll give you treasures in darkness and hidden riches of secret, that you may know I am the Lord who called you by my name. I am God of Israel. Praise God. Those are the promises that God have given us to us. That God shall make every crooked place straight. God is going to break every gate of bronze. Every gate, every obstacle. Hallelujah. Every walls of Jericho. Hallelujah. God will bring them down. Oh, because he loves you. Amen. He continues and saying, God is going to give us the hidden riches and treasures of darkness. That means we have been predestined for great destiny in our life in Jesus' name. Amen. God is going to give us the riches of the utajiri wa mataifa, sababu tumemwamini yeye, Mungu atatupatia. Hallelujah. Now, let us see an example. When God remembers a person, wakati umekubukwa na Jehovah. Hallelujah. Fungua nami in the book of Genesis 30, 22. Genesis 30, 22. When God remembers you, what will happen? Let be your prayer and my prayer this afternoon that may God remember us. Gai aroto lirikana. Hallelujah. The Bible says in the book of Genesis 30, 22, and God remembered Rachel. Yes, that means there was a time Rachel was going hard situation. There was a time Rachel was crying. There was a time Rachel lived in distress. Hallelujah. Now here comes, and God remembered Rachel, and God hearkened unto her. Hallelujah. That means when God was silent, Rachel was still calling upon God. Amen. There are those situations and seasons where this seems to be dark. Hallelujah. Don't give up. Don't keep quiet. Keep calling unto God. Amen. When God remembered Rachel, he hearkened unto her. May God hearken to our prayers this afternoon. Amen. When God hearkens to someone's prayer, and yeye Mungu akisikia maombi yako, hanyamazi, hutenda jambo. Hallelujah. In the book of Exodus 3, verse 7, God says, I have seen, I have heard, I have come to deliver my people of Israel from the land of bondage. That means when God hearkened to our cries, when God hearkened to our prayers, God comes and do something new. God comes and give us a new song. Hallelujah. In the book of Psalms 40, David says and witnesses, I patiently waited for God. Hallelujah. And when God came, he gave him a new song. Hallelujah. So may God hear your prayer this afternoon. May God give you a new song. Amen. Amen. May God give you a new song this afternoon. You have sung the songs of Kohara Kusota for so long. It is our season, it is our time to be remembered by God. The Bible says, when God remembered Rachel, he hearkened to her. Something else happened to Rachel. When God remembered Rachel, remember, Rachel was barren. Hallelujah. Rachel alikuwa tasa. Yani, hakupata watoto. Hallelujah. Nasema hivi, when God remembered Rachel, he opened her womb. That means, when God remembers you, you shall become productive. Hallelujah. When God remembers you, my brother and my sister, hallelujah, this must change. Hallelujah. There shall be a turning point in your life. Hallelujah. When God remembered Rachel, he opened her womb. That means, hapo awali, alikuwa amekosa nguvu za kupata mtoto. Hallelujah. Maybe you have been in business. Umekuwa tu unangangana. Kuna wakati wako wa prosper. Hallelujah. When God remembered Rachel, something else. She conceived. Hallelujah. That means when God remembered Rachel conceived. May you conceive a dream and a vision that you turn your life. Hallelujah. That one day you shall be celebrated in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's continue. Then she bore a son. Alipokumbukwa, hallelujah, akazaa mtoto kijana, hallelujah. That means a son represents a generation, hallelujah. Yani, mtoto kijana, yeye usimamia kizazi, hallelujah. When God remembered Rachel, she bore a son. That son was a son with a destiny. Aliitwa Joseph, the prime minister. That means, Mungu akikumbuka wewe, hali inabadilika. Change inaonekana. Hallelujah. Let's continue. When God remembered Rachel, God took away the reproach. Yani, Mungu alipomkumbuka Rakeli, alimuondolea aibu. Hey, that means Mungu akikumbuka mimi na wewe, kila aibu yote lazima itasonga katika jina la Yesu. Hallelujah. Mungu akikumbuka wewe, watu wako na watu huzoea kuita watu na shida zao. Unasikianga modoria yule mtu ambaye anakuanga kiugumizi, yule mtu ambaye anakuanga the bread but Myers. That means what you cause people with their weaknesses sometimes. But when God remembered Rachel, Mungu alipomtazama hakuona utasa wake. Hallelujah. Alipomkumbuka alimuondolea aibu. Hallelujah. What kind of reproach are you passing through? Hallelujah. Maybe biashara yako imepromoka, imeisha. May God remember you in Jesus' name. Amen. Maybe some of our members, some don't come to church. Nanchawa. Wamehepa sababu ya corona. May God remember this church in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's continue. So, when God remembers a person, he takes away the reproach. Reproach ni aibu. Kila aibu yote katika jina la Yesu lazima yende in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Let's continue. Verse 24. Then God gave him a son. The son was called Joseph. Joseph the prime minister. Hallelujah. Joseph the great prime minister of that land. That means when God remembers you, He anafanya jambo ambalo ni continuous. Amen. I remember sometimes back I was in school. We did arabe to look for money for me to pay my school fees. We had targeted, I had a fees balance of that 5,000 Kenya money. But let me tell you, brothers and sisters, after we did the harabe the whole day, we got 6,000. And we had spent 6,000. The end of the day, we had 7,000. There was an increase of one. Praise God. Then, when I was almost to give up, when I went back to school, it was just wow. And you saw, the headmaster told me, go and see the school bazaar. The school bazaar said, my son, don't worry. All your school fees and balances have been cleared through the PTA and BOG of the school. Hallelujah. That means, watu wakikuacha, Mungu atakukumbuka. Amen. Aibu yote ni Mungu tuondoa. Amen. Let's continue because of time. When God remembered Rachel, he increased the faith of Rachel. Rachel testified, may God add me another son. That means when God remembers you, God is going to build up your faith. Amen. When God shall build up your faith, you shall become an encourager to others. Amen. You shall have a testimony. You shall tell in them, no matter what you might pass through, God is faithful. Amen. Now, as I conclude, remember, God always keep trusting God. Whatever he has promised will come to pass in Jesus' name. Amen. Isaiah 55 verse 11, as I finish. Isaiah 55 verse 11. So shall the word of God go forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish which I am preached, and it shall prosper the thing which I said it for. Hallelujah. Mungu anaponena, maneno yake haimurudii bure. Hallelujah. Kama Jehova amesema atakuinua, hakika Mungu ni mwaminifu, atakuinua. Amen. Mungu amesema atakubariki. Continue to wait upon him. Hallelujah. God's word does not return to him void until it accomplishes what God had purposed, in Jesus' name. This afternoon, there are so many promises that you have heard because God made you to hear them, because God is still coming to accomplish them, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. So keep your faith high. Keep waiting. Keep focused unto God. And one day, you shall sing a new song in Jesus' name. May God bless you. May God increase you. May God lift you. Amen.